Hi everyone. This is the second episode of Utena Explained, where I'll be looking at a specific moment in an episode of Utena. Today, we'll be looking at the student council scene in episode 2 of Utena and answering an age-old question almost every Utena fan has asked at one point or another. What's the deal with Miki's stopwatch? So, to get right into it. Here in episode 2, For Whom the Rose Smiles, we have our second scene with the student council. These student council scenes happen repeatedly throughout the show, but are especially common in the first season. After the chick speech, we see the council discussing Utena with our favorite border roses. I've mentioned this in another video, but notice that Toga's frame contains white roses, even though his color is ostensibly red. As Toga is a duplicitous young man acting out the role of a prince, it's fitting that the border here is the white color associated with the prince instead of the red color associated with lust and power, which usually shows up when Toga is around. Miki and Juri are both framed in blue here, perhaps to represent their idealistic hopes, but more likely because there wasn't enough screen time to give Juri her own frame. As the council explains to the viewer their relationship to End of the World and the rules of the dueling game, we see that they are playing a card game, which I believe is Go Fish. The players are too preoccupied discussing the rules of the dueling game to ask for cards like you normally would in Go Fish, but the mechanics of the game, where players take cards from each other's hands and lay them down in pairs, seem to match Go Fish to a T. The symbolism here is relatively straightforward, but as the series continues, the activities that the student council perform become more esoteric. The student council is taking part in a dueling game, and so they play a game of cards. There can only be one winner, and there are defined rules which they cannot control. Go Fish is also a children's card game, which emphasizes that the student council are themselves childish. As the series continues, we will see that each of the duelists is obsessed with their childhoods, in their own particular way, and the childlike nature of Go Fish emphasizes this. As Toga explains that whoever wins the duels will win Auntie and enter the Castle of Eternity, he lays down his final pair, winning the game. We see that the winning pair consists of two Joker cards emblazoned with the Rose Seal. Normally when playing a card game, the Joker cards are removed, so why are they included here? I think that it's to show that the dueling game is not what it appears to be, and at the end of the game will not play by the standard rules. It's not a coincidence that while Toga explains the end of the dueling game, he ends the card game they are playing in an unconventional way, because the end of the dueling game will not follow the established rules. It could also mean that End of the World is playing a joke upon the duelists, tricking them into participating in the duels. Finally, the scene ends with Miki stopping his stopwatch at 16 seconds and 42 milliseconds. The mystery of what Miki's watch means is a question which has been asked since Utena was released. While there's no one definitive answer for what the stopwatch means, I'm going to give interpreting it a shot here. Firstly, Miki is the secretary of the student council and takes the minutes of their meetings, and the stopwatch could be used to help him record what was said and when. Interestingly, you can go back by the amount of time on the stopwatch, and someone will usually be saying something important. For this scene, going back 16 seconds, Toga is beginning to explain the rules of the dueling game. It's hard to say how much meaning there is to this, because it could be coincidental. With Utena, I doubt that anything is a coincidence, but without making a thorough catalog of every time the stopwatch appears, I can't have a firm opinion. For the stopwatch times I checked, they did correspond to a line of dialogue, but since I think almost every line of dialogue is important in Utena, I didn't see any particular connections between them. Second, Miki, perhaps even more so than the rest of the duelists, is obsessed with regaining a specific moment from his past, the sunlit garden where he played piano with his sister Kazue. Miki's memory of that garden is something he longs to return to, though we later learn his memory is flawed and the idealized past Miki remembers is an illusion. Having lost his seemingly pure relationship with his sister, Miki is determined not to let another moment pass him by unappreciated. He carries the stopwatch with him to make sure his memory of each event is as clear as it can be, so that he can hold on to each memory as strongly as he possibly can. Miki is a somewhat anal-retentive character, so it makes sense that to preserve his memories, he would resort to a stopwatch. A third possible meaning comes from the director himself. Apologies in advance for pronunciation errors. According to a fan translation of a 1997 Animage interview with Utena's director, Kunihiko Ikuhara, Miki using the stopwatch is connected with the structure of the world. After everyone laughs, the chief screenwriter and character designer, Enokido Yoji, says, "That's a really hard to understand answer." Ikuhara has a habit of not being very serious or clear in his interviews, so this is par for the course. I think with a little digging though, we can figure out what he means. At Atori Academy, time doesn't seem to function normally. To give some examples, in Season 2, Utena and Wakaba discuss taking finals, which would normally indicate that time is progressing. However, the seasons at Atori never change, and school seems to continue on as normal, even though school should be out after finals. Next, Anthe and Akio are both implied to be much older than they physically appear. At the end of Season 2, Akio says, "As long as people live in these gardens called schools, people will never become adults," to explain why he and Mikage haven't aged while Tokiko has grown old. Atori seems to exist in a timeless state, which emphasizes the arrested development of all the main cast. It is not until they leave the school that the characters can age and mature. While they are trapped in Akio's system, they cannot advance. Ikuhara's answer that Miki's watch relates to the structure of the world could be referencing this warped sense of time. Perhaps Miki has realized that something is wrong with how time functions at Atori, and obsessive as he is, has decided to catalog it. While I think that that's a fun theory, I'm more inclined to believe that the use of the stopwatch is just another reference to the theme of time and its passage, or lack thereof, which comes up a lot in Utena. Miki stops the watch at moments which he thinks are important and that he wants to hold on to, and then time stops progressing on the watch, just like how Mikage holds on to his memory of the past and time stops for him. Fourth, and finally, I think that the stopwatch looks cool, and this point cannot be overstated. The stopwatch makes a nice punctuation mark to a scene or moment, which is exactly how it's used here to end the duelist's conversation and transition to the next scene. And I think this also marks a good spot to end this video. I hope you got something out of it and that I haven't just been wasting your time. Thanks for watching. Now for boring channel stuff. It's been a long time since the last upload, and I'm hoping that I can increase these videos' frequency. I appreciate you for sticking around. I had actually made and uploaded another version of this episode where I discussed the scene where Utena confronts Sionji, but I made a really basic mistake and confused the astrological signs for Virgo and Scorpio. After writing and recording about 7 minutes worth of analysis about how Virgo relates to Anthe, I released it and my mistake was very quickly pointed out. I deleted the video because it was basically totally worthless, and if you were one of the 20 people who watched that before I deleted it, I'm sorry that I wasted your time. And I'm surprised you're still here, honestly. To sum up, I'm not really qualified to make these videos, and you probably shouldn't be listening to me. Yet, here I am again, and here you are, listening. Bye, and thanks again for watching. Hope to see you next time.